Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. In today's video I'm doing a skincare routine video, so I'm going to show you my morning skincare and my evening, like every single product I use in the day and also products that I don't use daily but I still use weekly. I'm also going to show in this video, so it's going to be quite an informative video in terms of the products. So I'm literally just going to sit here, talk through each product and overlay a clip of me using them. Won't overlay a clip of me using every single one, but I'll try and show as much as I can and not make this video too rambly or too long because I do have a habit of doing that. So without further ado, let's get into the video. So let's begin with my morning skincare routine. So I will wake up in the morning and I have my, you know, residue of skincare from the previous night, and hopefully it's drawn out impurities and whatever, and I will wash my face.
So this is my face wash.
This is my face wash that I use. This is the Body Shop Lemon Purifying Face Wash. It says it helps wash away bacteria and impurities, which is amazing because that is exactly what I need in the morning. This is a recent purchase. I'm actually including this in a haul next week, a Body Shop kind of first impressions haul. So this is like a little sneak peek to that video. But yeah, I love this. It's leaking down my arm. I've just used it this morning. It's not the product leaking, it's water dripping off it. I am literally obsessed with this. I don't want to talk about it too much, but it makes my skin so, so soft. I am going to speak about this next week. But yeah, makes my skin so soft, foams up really nicely on the skin, the smell of it's super nice, and this is a real like strong contender for one of my all-time favourite face washes. I'm literally obsessed with it. And if you follow me on Instagram, which is linked in the description, you will know that I recently purchased this and I love it. So absolute winner with that one. So I'll wash my face with that in the morning. I then kind of like let my skin breathe for an hour or so, whatever, like don't apply any products, and then I will do like my like little mini skincare routine in the morning. I tend to keep it quite like stripped back and basic in the morning because I don't like to have loads of skincare on my face underneath my makeup because it can affect the way that my makeup looks and applies. But the first product that I use is actually my own product from my own skincare business, which I will link in the description. I've got a small skincare business, it's called Fresh Faced. I will link my Etsy and my eBay if you're interested. Obviously I use my own product, I always will do, because I wouldn't, you know, bring something out I'm not going to use myself. But this is the Fresh Face by Georgie Carr Hydrating Gel Moisturizer. This has got glycerin in it, it's got aloe vera in it, so it's super hydrating for the skin, and it's just basically one of those products that looks glowy on the skin but also gives that like level of moisture. So yeah, I love that. I'm a gel moisturizer kind of person rather than a like cream consistency moisturizer because I like how glowy they look. So this is my product, it will be linked in the description. The actual packaging of mine doesn't look so great because I've had this a while, and when I refill my own products I refill the same packaging, so that's why it looks a bit dirty. Don't worry, they don't come like this when you order one. But yeah, I use that. And then the second product that I use is my SPF. This is the Body Shop Skin Defense Multi Protection Lotion. This is SPF 50. I like this, it's very good. I would highly recommend to use SPF every single day because it's important to make sure that your skin is protected from the sun, even throughout the winter, because the sun is still out. Like if the sun wasn't out, you know, at all, we would all be dead. So the sun is still always there. You still have to wear SPF in the daytime to protect your skin at all times, to prevent aging and things like that and worse things. But yeah, I like this one. I do have to say though, I will be rebuying the Body Shop Vitamin C Glow Protect Lotion, which is the SPF 30 I think, or something like that, because I much prefer that one because it's glowier and it blends nicer, but this one's good as well. So that's literally it, moisturizer, SPF, done. I do also apply a little bit of lip balm. This is my lip balm, it's just from Nivea, the Nivea Hydro Care SPF 15 lip balm. Didn't even know this had SPF in it, so glad I did this video because now I know. Again, if you're protecting your skin with SPF, you need to also protect your lips because your lips is still part of your skin. It's just not something that we think about. So yeah, everything like that is important. So I use that, and that is everything for my morning skincare. This is what my skin looks like when I have finished my skincare routine. It's kind of slightly glowy, but not overly so. And it's a nice base for makeup. There's glycerin in my moisturizer, which means that when I apply my makeup, it's like a nice kind of tacky base to pop the makeup on, and it lasts longer throughout the day. So now we are coming to the evening. I have applied my makeup. This is what my makeup looks like today, and I'm ready to take it off. So I tend to take off my makeup just before I go and do a workout. The product that I use to take my makeup off is my cleansing balm. So this is the Fresh Face by Georgie Carr Lemon Scented Cleansing Balm. Again, this is on my Etsy and my eBay. I swear not every product in this video is what I make myself, by the way. And this is lemon scented, so I love the smell of this. I'm actually running low on this. I think this is the fourth time I've refilled my own product. I use it daily. Even when I've not applied makeup, I will still use this product because I still have skincare on my face that needs removing. I will always double cleanse whether I'm wearing makeup or not. Also, SPF, if you're wearing SPF in the morning, you have to remove that in the evening. So I would recommend double cleansing. But yeah, I use some of this. I rub it into my skin. I literally just rub all over my makeup, eyes, everything like that. It removes everything and it just melts away your makeup. And then I will take a cloth or something like that and just a damp one, and I will just wipe that away. This is my first cleanse, so I will go in and cleanse after that. But yeah, I just wipe it away and it saves on wet wipes and things like that and helps the environment because you're not using wet wipes. And it's actually a much easier product to use. For me personally, I think this is much easier to use than any other makeup like removal thing. So this is the makeup removal step, and it also nourishes your skin at the same time. So yeah, like I said, I do double cleanse, so I will just go back in with my lemon purifying face. I cannot say that for the life of me. The lemon purifying face wash, I will go in after that, and that's my second cleanse. Also, I do have a soap which is actually in my shower from the Body Shop. It's the grapefruit one, and whenever I shower, which is daily, I use that. So if I have a shower, I will also use that soap in addition to all of this skincare, because I like how fresh it makes my skin feel. So I will then leave my skin to like breathe for a few hours. I'll do a workout, etc., and then I will use a face mask. So I'm going to show you the different face masks that I've got. I actually have a system. So one day I will use my Himalayan charcoal purifying glow mask, which is what I used yesterday. I focus this on my T-zone and any kind of spots. This is a great mask for like if you've got oily skin or anything like that. I love the smell of this, and this is a great mask. I would recommend. And then the next night, because I do a face mask every single day because that's just what works for me, that's just what I enjoy to do, it's part of my routine, I will pop a face mask on and go and do the washing up, and then when I finish washing up, it's ready to take it off in the shower. But tonight I'm using my Fresh Face by Georgie Carr Detox Clay Face Mask. This is also what is on my eBay and Etsy that I make and sell myself. I love this mask. I'm actually increasing the price of this, and I think when this video goes up, the price will be increasing today. So I'm sorry, it's already gone up. I really love this mask. It's a clay mask. It's great for probably, I would say, oilier skin to combination skin, but any skin type can use this. I love the smell of it. It's tea tree, and yeah, I love this mask, and I am going to be using this tonight, so I will show you a demo of me using this later on. And leave it on for 10 to 15 minutes and then wash it off, and it washes off really quickly as well, which I like. I am redoing the labels as well, something different. Then the following night I will use my Zuku Australian based hemp clay mask. This is not my favorite mask, so I'm kind of just getting this to like use it up, but it is like another clay mask. It's quite thick. I'm not massively keen on really thick clay masks because I feel like I'm just dragging my skin as I apply it. So yeah, it's nice, but it's not amazingly nice, and I'm just kind of using it up. Then, because you know we've had 3 days of using clay face masks, I will go in with some kind of more moisturizing one. So either I will use my Revolution Feed Your Face Avocado Face Mask, which looks like this. This is so nice. This is really nourishing, and it makes my skin feel super soft. And yeah, I really love this one, actually. I 100% will be repurchasing that. Or I will go in with my NICU Acuron Coffee Intense Awakening Mask from the Body Shop, which is also really nice. It's kind of got like little scrubby bits in it, so it kind of exfoliates slightly as you're putting it on anyway, and it makes my skin nice and glowy. So yeah, those are my face masks that I kind of interchange and use throughout the week. I use a different one basically every single day, and it just means that my skin is getting different benefits from different face masks. I do also like to use sheet masks too occasionally, about once a week, and Lidl sells some good ones for about 70p, so would recommend them. Like I said, every day I use a face mask. After I use my face mask and I washed it off, I will let my skin again breathe and just you know, have no product on it. And then I will go in with my evening skincare routine. So here starts the routine. Let's begin. First of all is this. This is the Body Shop CBD Restoring Facial Oil. This I pop on first. I don't know what order of products I'm meant to pop on at what point in time, but I pop this on first because I like how it feels on my skin. It's super hydrating, it's softening to the skin more than anything, and it gives a nice glow. I love this. Then I use my Body Shop British Rose Toner. Unfortunately, I'm getting to the end of it, which means that there's loads of petals in the bottom, which is kind of annoying because they go on my face and look ridiculous. But this is kind of nice. It's a gel-like toner and it feels very plumping on the skin. And I like that. It's, you know, very much up my street, apart from the loose petals. I don't like those. But when this runs out, I'm going to switch to a different toner because I like to mix it up when it comes to my skincare. Then I have two products that I use one after the other. I was sent these and I filmed a video with these, which is on my channel. So just research Georgie Carr Skin Diva and it will come up. But this is the Skin Diva 20% Vitamin C and E with Ferulic Acid Serum. So this is like a vitamin C kind of product and I love this. I really, really do. It makes my skin super glowy and I'm gonna be sad when this goes. I'll probably get like a substitute from The Ordinary or something like that. But yeah, I really, really would highly recommend this if you like glowy skin, because this definitely gives that. And then also from Skin Diva, we've got the Matrixyl Synthe something serum with hyaluronic acid. All I know from this is that it's got hyaluronic acid in it, and I've nearly finished this. It actually runs out quite quickly because I use a lot of it because I love it. It's super hydrating to the skin. It's quite tacky when you put it on, but that's because of the hydration of the product, and I really like this. I think out of the two of them, I much prefer the vitamin C one, but that's because I just like the glow that it gives. And this one is a little bit kind of tacky on the skin, but love both of them. They're very good quality products. Next up, I have this, which is not an essential in my skincare routine. It's just something I wanted to try because I got 50% off. But this is the Body Shop Vitamin E Skin Cooling Gel Mist. This is, I've spoken about this many times, it's a bit of a weird product. It's a gel in a spray bottle. It doesn't spray out very well. It's nice and cooling on the skin. It kind of feels like a serum on my skin. I just use it because I've got it. I don't see any skincare benefits from it. I don't think it should really have a place in my skincare routine, and I won't be repurchasing it, but it's all right. It's nice and cooling. Maybe in the summer it'll be nice, but I'm not gonna lie to you, it's just, it's a bit meh, really. Nothing good, nothing necessarily bad, but yeah. Then we have this, which is very much nearly run out. In fact, after this video, I think it'll probably have run out. But this is the Body Shop Roots of Strength Firming Shaping Essence Lotion. I had the Essence Lotion, which was the Drops of Youth one from the Body Shop. I also have the Oils of Life one, which I will be finishing that after this one because I still got a bit of that left. This is super nice and plumping to the skin. I personally think that when I've run out of my Essence Lotions, I won't be repurchasing them because I don't really see a point in them. Apparently, you apply them before your moisturiser to help your moisturiser sink in more, but that's probably just a marketing tactic and it's probably just some kind of like, you know, I don't think it's true, but even if it is, I don't care. I don't particularly think that it's needed in my skincare routine anyway, but I did like this, and it is targeted at much older skin than mine, literally 40 plus. I got this when I was doing the Body Shop at home, so I have obviously been using it, but yeah, it did make my skin nice and plump, so I can't complain, but it is literally run out, and I will be using the Oils of Life one next. But an essence lotion isn't something I'm gonna be adding back into my skincare routine. And then after that, I will then go in with my moisturizer, my hydrating gel moisturizer that I sell myself, which I mentioned previously. I will go in with this and then after that. And then a little kind of eye gel. This is the Vitamin C Brightening Eye Gel from Boots. I really love this. Pop it underneath my eyes and on my eyes, and it actually feels kind of cooling and nice. Don't know if it does anything, but we're here to just throw products on our face for the fun of it and see what happens. And then finally, I will do like my spot kind of treatment stage. I have two products. I have my tea tree oil, which I sell on my website. This is the Fresh Base by Georgie Carr Pure Tea Tree Oil. I will either use that, like little droplets of that, or I will use my Mario Badescu drying lotion. Now, I had this bottle and I used the whole thing, and then I thought, you know what, I'm gonna try something different and then come back to this because I like to try different products and different things. And I really wanted to try this. I've always wanted to try this product because it just looks so cool. You dip your cotton pad into it and then you go into like the powdery mixture at the bottom. pop it on your spots and it dries your spots out overnight, and you wake up in the morning and you can still see that, but your spots are reduced. I would say it's on par with the tea tree oil. It works just kind of the same, looks different, and I kind of like how it looks on my skin. Like, it just makes me feel like I'm doing my skincare good because you can see it. But I don't really see much of a difference from when I did use my tea tree oil. I'm zoomed in. We're zoomed in. I forgot to mention that I actually finish off my skincare routine in the evening by using this lip balm from Nivea. Sorry, I forgot to mention it. I'm zoomed in because I'm filming the overlay clips where I like hold the product up. But yeah, here we are. I use that, forgot to mention, didn't want to be dishonest, so there we go. I need to hurry up because I've got a lecture in 4 minutes. But yeah, so that's basically my skincare routine every single day. Now, the odd bits and bobs that I will use weekly. So once a week, I use my Fresh Face by Georgie Carr Vanilla Coffee Body Scrub. It is mainly a body scrub, but I will also use this as like a little facial scrub if you're careful. It's a nice kind of exfoliant for your face, so that's nice. So I will use that. And then once a week, I also use one of these. These are the Beauty Formulas with Activated Charcoal Nose Pore Strips. There's 6 of these. £1.50 on Amazon for 6 of these, and I got free delivery because I have Amazon Prime. I have like a free 6-month trial or something because I'm a student. Yeah, one of these a week. I love that. Just pop it on my nose. Also, once a week, I will use this. This is the Body Shop Drops of Youth Liquid Peel. Prefer the vitamin C one, but this one's nice as well. Will I repurchase this kind of a thing? No, because I'm just not a believer that the product is, you know, what it says it is. Basically, like, it's nice, but when it comes to exfoliation, I like scrubs or acids. I don't think this really has a place in my skincare routine once I've run out of that. On days when I don't wear makeup, I will actually use a like overnight mask throughout the day so that I'm kind of taking advantage of the fact that I'm not wearing makeup. I have 2 of them. This one is the Vitamin C Brightening Sleeping Mask from Boots, which is really, really nice. It's like a gel kind of consistency.
Oh, crud. That nearly went everywhere.
Let me just deal with this. The good thing about when you spill skincare is you can just keep rubbing it into your skin and eventually it will disappear. but yeah, I've got that one. It's nice. It makes my skin really, really glowy. So if I'm going to go to the shop in the day and I use this, I don't tend to because my skin is a literal glow ball. This is for like when I'm at home. And I also have this one from the Body Shop, which is the Vitamin E Sink in Moisture Sleeping Mask. This is super, super softening to the skin. If you've got dry skin, you will love this if you want to use it overnight or if you want to use it in the day when you're not wearing makeup. I think that may be everything. Oh my God, have I mentioned everything? Yeah, I think that is everything. So yeah, I couldn't show an overlay of every single product because this video would take me too long to film, but I will try and overlay as much as I can. But yeah, that's it for this video. That is my full skincare routine. Things will change. My skincare is ever adapting and changing and all that kind of thing. And I like it. In April, when I get my student loan, I'm gonna purchase a few new bits from The Ordinary, but I'm just kind of using up a few current bits that I've got now and then I can substitute them in. It's just products that I've heard that are really good, so yeah. So yeah, I'm excited for that, but that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I will film another one of these in a few months' time when my skincare routine is like adapted and changed. But until then, that's it. So if you've got any questions, leave them in the comments. But thank you for watching, and please subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye.